If you want to be able to send more complex parameters to query or modify data to your Nest.js GraphQL API, in this quick tips episode, you will learn how. Keep watching. Hi there. I'm Manuel Gutierrez from thelighthouse.co, and I make videos that help you learn about different programming topics like AM, Docker, TensorFlow, Unity, and more. So if you're new here, hit the subscribe and the bell notification buttons below so you don't miss a thing. Let's start. In previous videos, I created a simple Nest.js server that queries parent quizzes with their nested child questions. And finally, a mutation to modify existing data. In this video, I will create another mutation that receives a more complex input object so that we can add new questions to the quizzes inside our Nest.js application. Let's define an input type for our questions. Import input type field and int from nestjs/graphql. Using the input type decorator, create the question input type and export it. Add one field of type int for the quiz ID, and similar to the question object type, add the text and is markdown fields. Add to the quizzes service an add question method that receives the question input type. Within the list of quizzes, look for the first quiz that has a matching quiz ID. Create an object for the new question with the new text and its markdown properties. Then add the new question into the questions array on the quiz and return the question. On the quizzes resolver, import the new question input. Using the mutation decorator configured to return a single question, create a method called addQuestion that receives as an argument a question input type. From the quizzes service, call the addQuestion method and pass the question parameter. Finally, return the results. Finally, restart the server. Go to localhost /graphql, which will open the GraphQL playground inside your browser. As before, create a new tab. Click on Query Variables. Add a JSON object called question. Add the values for the quiz ID, text, and is markdown properties. As before, at the top, type mutation, and in this case, define a name for it. For parameters, use the $, the name of the JSON object that you created before, and set the type as question input. Then type add question, which is the name of the mutation defined on the resolver. And as the question parameter, type $ and question. Finally, provide the fields that you want to be returned after the question has been added. In future videos, I will show how to consume the services created here using client applications. Awesome! Congratulations and thanks for watching! You can join the free mini course associated with this video by clicking on the link in the description below. Share any comments or suggestions about the series or future topics. And if you like the video, also hit the like button below.